For my museum inspiration piece, I chose one of the paper clay sculptures. Tomoko Kono's creature spoke to me the most. This piece made my head spin with design possibilities. The piece is a very unique and fun shape with shades of gray and pink. I decided to design a jacket based off of this piece. The jacket is mostly gray like the sculpture, with a marble light gray and white bottom. Like the sculpture, I chose to add hints of pink. I used pink for the pockets, one inset pocket and one patch pocket for a unique look.
I wanted to design a piece of clothing that took inspiration from Thomas Campbell's art and lifestyle. Thomas Campbell is from Dana Point, California, a small town known for its renowned surfing. My goal is to create an article of clothing that resembles the city and could be worn by the local surfers as well. This pullover anorak windbreaker is the perfect piece of clothing to wear to and from the waves every day, skate in the roads, or cruising throughout the city. I used the bright contrasting oranges and turquoise to mimic the color and used clean lines to resemble the form of the painting. The jacket also reminds me of the warm and cool colors that perfectly contrast throughout the California coastline.
I chose this paper clay piece because of its minimalistic design. I wanted to make a piece that was inspired by the art but focused more on the user. I decided to go the route of thinking up who would own this type of art. The modern styling of the art made me think of future cities and users that would spend time both downtown and out in nature. I wanted an item that blended the modern art piece with a style inspired by retro artists' interpretation of the future. I decided to go with magnets for the closure to give the jacket a clean look when worn open or closed. I wanted a trench coat style that had hints of more technical garments, so I added the back vent. The angles in the design also help to give an overall more technical look to the jacket.
I was inspired by this mixed media art piece, and I chose to embody its form through the construction of my jacket. I chose to quilt the jacket and make it overly puffy to match the shape of the art piece. As soon as I saw this art piece, I was drawn in by the block printing on the canvas. I wanted to recreate the tone of the art piece by incorporating the media into the jacket.
I fell in love with this car picture. There was so much to it, so much design, so much color. My eye was drawn to the family. Even though there were crazy lines and colors everywhere, the family seemed so sound and calm. So I went forward with that decision in making my design calm. I chose a simple blue fabric that resembled what I saw the most color and a second color of pink, which is involved in my thread. I chose to do a scallop bow wrap skirt to resemble the lines, but to keep it simple, I added buttons on each of the scallops to add closures and to resemble the car wheels. I'm really happy with how my design turned out, and I think it resembles it well.
I chose to imitate the quilted animal for a couple of reasons. For one, the piece caught my attention. When I saw it, I believed it truly represented the initial ideas and thoughts behind most of Thomas Campbell's other pieces. It incorporated odds and ends from his studio, life, etc. I love this piece because to me, it demonstrated how the thought process is just as important as the final work. The second reason I chose this was because of the challenge it presented. Incorporating my own inspirations and items from my studio was difficult because the garment had to still be functional, being a best pack that any skate, surf, and snow-oriented designer and artist could wear to get their job done. The best pack has a removable tool belt, backpack-like storage, and straps for a board. Thank you, Thomas Campbell, for the inspiration behind this project.
As I designed around this sculpture, when I started, I think I was actually taking this assignment and this project a little too literally, but then as I worked back through the design process, I kind of was able to see what things I wanted to keep and what things to take off, and I kind of ended up with this dress where, you know, I kept some like the color palette and was really inspired by the holes in the sculpture to kind of use this eyelet fabric, and then the tentacles, if you will, at the bottom of the sculpture give way to this piece around the neck. It was really interesting and fun to try and create something that was an art piece and as beautiful as the sculpture that it was based off of. I'm really proud of it.
For my half-scale fashion piece, I drew my inspiration from a piece called Hungnail Quilt Animal, created by Thomas Campbell. I chose this piece because I love the handmade, authentic feel it has. His unfinished edges, zigzag stitching, hand-painted designs, and bright colors were all aspects of his piece that I wanted to highlight in my own half-scale fashion project. I decided to create a simple long-sleeved shift dress with a color-blocked back to highlight some of the quilting Thomas featured in his art piece. I emulated several of his hand-painted designs, zigzag stitching, and bright colors. For the front, I drew my inspiration from the brown leaf located on the far side of the display. I knew immediately I wanted this to be the focal point of my project, so I incorporated it onto the front of the dress. Overall, I thoroughly enjoyed this project. It made me think outside the box and think about more creative solutions.
The reason I chose this art piece is because I love the way that Thomas Campbell pieced together his artwork out of lots of different materials that you wouldn't normally think to use for a quilt. He used money, he used bubble wrap, he used tarpaulin. To me, it's almost like a metaphor for as we go throughout our lives. We piece together our personalities and our lives based on those we come in contact with. Those interactions stitch together the quilt of our lives. And that is what I wanted to bring when I made my piece. I have dollar bills and various materials that you would not necessarily think to put all together into one piece. And I think it's very beautiful.